Tori Were, the former Attorney General of the Federation and Minister nominee of President Muhammadu Buhari, Abubakar Malami, says the Petroleum Industry Governance Bill, PIGB, was rejected because it lacks in merit of most communities. Malami said when he appeared before the Senate during Friday's screening of the ministerial nominees.
Responding to questions from the Senate, former Attorney General of the Federation and ministerial nominee of President Muhammadu Buhari, Abubakar Malami, revealed that the presidency declined assent to the Petroleum Industrial Bill because of the interests of host communities was not prioritized. The former Attorney General of the Federation stressed that public interest should at all times supersede individual interest in any democracy, whilst also responding to questions bothering on protection of rights of individuals as asked by Senator Eyunaya Abaribe.
Section 36, 37, 38, 39, all the way to, I think, 44, puts all the rights including you there. And as Attorney General, I'm sure you are the person who guarantees the rights of Nigerians. And so I want to ask you, why? Or would you be able kind to explain to Nigerians why you as Attorney General has not been able to guarantee the rights of those Nigerians who have been granted bail and are still in custody?
I want to reiterate and state further that the office of the Attorney General is meant to protect public interest, and where the individual interest conflicts with the public interest, the interest of 180 million Nigerians that are interested in having this country integrated must naturally prevail. That bill was fundamentally rejected, among others, by the president because of the fact that the interest of the host community was at a point compromised. Compromised in which way? Compromised in the sense that self-serving sections were brought into it, conferring powers on an individual as against the institution. And the public interest element of the role of the president requires that the public interest should be factored more as against public or individual interest.
In another development, Senator representing Bayelsa West, Lawrence Erudiakpo, noted that most of the ministerial nominees have not submitted their asset declaration forms, raising all the one-to-one of the Senate standing rules during the screening of ministerial nominees in plenary on Friday. Senator Erudiakpo said it is a constitutional breach for such documents not to be presented.
The Senate shall not consider the nomination of any person who has held any public office as contained in Part 1 of the Fifth Schedule of the Constitution prior to its nomination unless there is a written evidence that he has declared his assets and liabilities as required by Section 1(3) of Part 1 of the Fifth Schedule to the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Mr. President, sitting as chair, mine is an appeal, though I'm rising under this order, to suggest that all the nominees who have been appearing before us, very few of them have presented their certificate of declaration of age, meaning a declaration of assets. I move that the National Assembly liaison should please facilitate their submission of those declarations, because all of us here before we were even sworn in and we took our oath of office, we declared our assets. And so I want to request or suggest that the Senate take this notice and ask them before we go into the confirmation stage, they submit such requirements.
Responding, Senate President Ahmed Lawan said his observation is noted and that the Senate will expedite action. While fielding questions from journalists, Senator Erudiakpo assured that before the confirmation stage, those that do not provide a document may be disqualified.
Still on the ministerial list, as the Senate